Do we even have J. Cole reactions on our shit?
Not enough.
Shit. All right, we got J. Cole, middle child. Let's get it.
You good, T-Money?
Oh my god, that Montana 300 middle child song was heat too. Remember that reaction we did? When,
Oh yeah, I remember.
Yo, Montana like bodied that fucking instrumental.
Niggas been counting me out. I'm counting my bullets. I'm loading my clips. I'm writing down names. I'm making a list. I'm checking it twice and I'm getting them hit. The real ones been dying. The fake ones is lit. The game is off balance. I'm back on my shit. The Bentley is dirty. My sneakers is dirty. But that's how I like it. You all on my dick. I'm all in my bag. As hard as it get. I do not throw powder. I might take a sip. I might hit the blunt, but I'm liable to trip. I ain't popping no pill, but you do as you wish. I roll with some fiends. I love them to death. I got a few mil, but not all of them rich. What good is the bread if my niggas is broke? What good is first class if my niggas can't?
Yo, I love his mentality, yo.
He's all about, like, not just him, but, like, his bros.
Yeah. And then he's talking about, like, his dirty sneakers. Like, he don't give a fuck.
No, he could care less.
You've seen J. Cole, he said, right?
Not all of them rich. What good is the bread if my niggas is broke? What good is first class if my niggas can't sit? That's my next mission. That's why I can't quit. Just like LeBron, get my niggas more chips. Just put the rollie right back on my wrist. This watch came from Drizzy.
Just like LeBron, give him more chips.
Mad props to him.
He's referring to, I mean, I don't know. People take pay cuts sometimes when they go on LeBron James team because he get paid.
If my niggas is broke, what good is first class if my niggas can't sit? That's my next mission, that's why I can't quit. Just like LeBron, get my niggas more chips. Just put the rollie right back on my wrist. This watch came from Drizzy, gave me a gift. Back when the rap game was praying like this. To act like two legends cannot coexist. But I never beef with a nigga for nothing. If I smoke a rapper, it's gonna be legit. It won't be for clout, it won't be for fame. It won't be cause my shit ain't selling the same. It won't be to sell you my latest little sneakers. It won't be cause some niggas slid in my lane. Everything grows, it's destined to change. I love you little niggas, I'm glad that you came. I hope that you scrape every dollar you came.
And he's so positive too.
Yeah. And like, he's very authentic too. Like, you'll never catch J. Cole just like doing something just for money.
Yeah. No, J. Cole is like, after like the whole like Eminem and 50 era, like that next group of rappers after them, like J. Cole and Kendrick Lamar was like my two favorite. I like A Boogie a lot. I feel like he came in like 5 years after them. I could be wrong. Could be completely wrong on that. But like J. Cole, after like the very first J. Cole song I heard was Workout.
Mm-hmm.
I thought Workout, that shit was my favorite. Yo, that was like my favorite song for a long time.
Actually, my first J. Cole song was Lights Please. That one really put me on him.
Yeah, but he has so many good songs. But like Return of Simba was straight fire. I don't know if you ever heard of Return of Simba. That shit was heat.
I liked Crooked Smile.
Love Yours was good.
Love Yours. Crooked Smile was good.
Apparently was fire. Oh, and then never mind.
Go rapper, it's gonna be legit. It won't be for clout, it won't be for fame. It won't be cause my shit ain't selling the same. It won't be to sell you my latest little sneakers. It won't be cause some niggas slid in my lane. Everything grows, it's destined to change. I love you little niggas, I'm glad that you came. I hope that you scrape every dollar you came. I hope you know money won't erase the pain. To the OGs, I'm thanking you now.
I hope you know money won't erase the pain.
And I love how he says, like, I hope you scrape every dollar. Like, don't let anyone take your money.
I was gonna say, money will erase some of my pain. It's a little bit.
Every dollar you came, I hope you know money won't erase the pain. To the OGs, I'm thanking you now. I was watching you when you was paving the ground. I copied your cadence, I mirrored your style. I studied the grace, I'm the greatest right now. Fuck if you feel me, you ain't got a choice. I ain't do no promo, still made all that.
He talks about being a student of the game.
Grace, I'm the greatest right now. Fuck if you feel me, you ain't got a choice. I ain't do no promo, still made all that noise. The shit gonna be different, I set my intentions. I promise to slap all that hate out your voice. Niggas been counting me out, I'm counting my bullets, I'm loading my clips, I'm writing their names, I'm making a list, I'm checking it twice and I'm getting them hit.
I love that scene. Wow, that's fucking weird.
Oh, look, he taxidermied three heads. Whose heads is those?
I can't tell. But you notice how, like, they were driving through the mud, kind of showing, like, him getting dirty?
Yeah, he came from the dirt.
Yeah. But also the line where he says, like, just know that all the money can't erase the pain. And I love that so much.
I'm loading my clips, I'm writing down names, I'm making a list, I'm checking it twice and I'm getting them hit. The real ones been dying, the fake ones is lit, the game is off balance, I'm back on my shit. The Bentley is dirty, my sneakers is dirty, but that's how I like it, you all on my dick.
Bro, he makes me want to wear my dirty sneakers again, yo.
Bentley is dirty, my sneakers is dirty, but that's how I like it, you all on my dick. I just poured something in my cup. I've been wanting something I can feel. Promise I am never letting up.
Money. I love that.
Wait, that guy with the green hair, isn't he supposed to portray like a rapper?
It could be. It could. Yeah, he's like your favorite rapper. It can portray a lot of different rappers.
I wonder which one.
I think he's referring to like just mumble rappers in general. But of course, like right away, what comes to my mind is like Tekashi, because Tekashi is probably like, he's probably the most successful rapper that's just, that has no lyrical ability.
Mm.
And not as an insult. I mean, he gets these catchy ass beats and he just knows how to perform on catchy beats and he brings energy. But like lyricism wise, there's no lyrical ability there. And I can say that about a lot of rappers that I hear now. I think King Von's a good rapper, but he's not very lyrical. But I don't think you have to be lyrical anymore. It's not like back then. Back then, you kind of had to have a lot of lyrical ability. You had to be like a Joyner or a Kendrick Lamar or a J. Cole or a Chance the Rapper. Like, you had to be lyrical, because back then, like, it came from like a lot of battle rapping. So lyrical ability was like almost like a must have. Now you don't need lyrical ability. You jump on a nice beat and you can make something catchy, like you'll be fine. Like Tekashi is a great example of that. You give him a catchy beat, he'll put on a good hook on it. No lyrical ability. He'll say some lines, but like J. Cole's obviously not one of those rappers. I've been wanting something I can feel. Promise I am never letting up. Money in your palm don't make you real. Foot is on a neck, I got him stuck. I'm gonna give them something they can feel. If it ain't about to swat, don't give a fuck. Pistol in your hand, I'm dead in the middle of two generations. I'm little bro and big bro all at once. Just left the lab with young 21 Savage. I'm about to go on me, jigger for lunch. Had a long talk with the young nigga Kodak. Reminded me of young niggas from Phil. Straight out the project, no faking, just honest. I wish that he had more guidance for real. Too many niggas in cycle of jail. Spending their birthdays inside of a cell. We coming from a long bloodline of trauma. We raised by our mamas, Lord, we gotta heal. We hurting our sisters, the babies as well. We killing our brothers, they poison the well. Distorted self-image, we settled the fair. He'd be dropping straight jewels, yo.
Everything he just fucking said was just fucking facts.
Oh my god, remember how packed supermarkets used to be before COVID? It makes me feel
less. I mean, it's been a while since we've actually shopped for food.
Yeah, that's true. But like, I remember the last time I was in the supermarket, them shelves did not stock. They were not in stock like those, yo.
Oh, they have mad coffee meat.
Oh my god, so much coffee meat. All that apple juice.
I love the meaning behind the song, like, middle child. He's stuck in a generation of, the generation of rappers he's talking about.
Yeah.
We killing our brothers, they poison the well. Distorted self-image, we settle the fair. I'ma make sure that the real gon' prevail, nigga. I just poured something in my cup. I've been wanting something I can feel. Promise I am never letting up. Money in your palm don't make you real. Foot is on a neck, I got them stuck. I'ma give them something they can feel. If it ain't about to swat, don't give a fuck. Pistol in your hand don't make you real.
The fuck? What was that about at the end?
I don't know.
Kind of weird.
Hmm.
But yeah, like J. Cole is fire, yo. And like, I don't know, it's like, the more I listen to, like when I listen to trending songs, it's almost like it still surprises me till this day. Like the songs that I listen to, like, are trending, and songs I think are really lyrical, they never get the same recognition. Like, in my opinion, like, Montana should get a lot more recognition than he does. Same with, like, Dax, because they're both very lyrical, and they touch on a lot of different topics, especially Dax. Like, his topics, like, kind of range a lot. Montana's more of, like, a gangster rapper, but he's just super lyrical.
Yeah, I agree. Like, the rappers that don't get enough recognition tend to be the rappers that are super motivational, super positive, and speak on important topics rather the trending stuff. Like, it just sounds good. Like, that's what it is. Like, it's catchy. You can't deny a catchy song. That's why it's trending. So, like, the measurement of trending music, I don't think is a good measurement of good music. It's just catchy music.
And I also think that, like, for some reason, like, it's like, if you're appealing to an overall audience, and that's what I was saying before, like, lyrical ability doesn't really matter anymore because the overall audience doesn't care for, like, tons of metaphors, similes, punchlines, schemes, storytelling. Because if that was the case, you'd have people like Dax and Tom McDonald, which they get recognized, but not to the extent that they should. Like, Hobson too. He's another one where, like, you see people like, and NBA YoungBoy is good. I think he's okay. And then you got, like, King Von. They're always trending.
Yeah.
And if I put, like, my personal preference, if I put King Von, NBA YoungBoy, like, even like Trippie Redd, Kid Laroi, side by side with like a Hobson, a Dax, a Tom McDonald, a Montana 300, for me, it wouldn't even be a comparison. But then again, that's just my opinion, I guess.
I think there's a lot of factors. I think there's a lot of influence from TikTok, obviously, of what's gonna be trending. And then think about, like, all the different types of people on YouTube, you know, like, not everyone likes this type of music.
Yeah.
So I don't know if it's ever gonna be to that level of, like, trending.
Yeah, I also think it's just a major shift. So I just think, like me watching that shift is surprising to me. Like, everyone else I speak to that's a bit on the older side, they see the transition. The transition is like again, like Joyner Lucas, I think, doesn't get the recognition he deserves to. Like, he's another one. There's a bunch, like Jelly Roll, isn't there? I think Jelly Roll is really good.
Jelly Roll.